Made for Success Publishing presents Chronic Blessings, Finding Life's Greatest Joys Within Your Deepest Heartache. Narrated by Ali Cheff. Written by Cristy Maddox. Audiobook copyright 2019 by Made for Success Publishing.
Introduction. As I sit clinging to my purse in the icebox, otherwise known as the Detroit Metro Airport, I have learned to set much of my pride aside for my own safety. I've had no choice. There are so many lessons I have had to learn the hard way, one of which I've just implemented, asking for help. However, as I sit here alone while the minutes tick by, I'm not sure if the help is coming. I'm not even sure if the woman at the counter understood what I was saying. I know that it is hard to understand me when my speech becomes slurred, and the panic that was starting to set in probably didn't help either. But I hope that she at least got the message that I need help. She told me to sit to the side and wait. So, I'm waiting. It's not as if I have any other choice. The terminal is now empty. All the other passengers have returned home or gone to find hotels. I just wish I knew what to do. As I begin to feel more and more alone, I can't help but wonder. If I were 80 and walked with a cane, would I have been left here for this long? And I can't believe that this is actually happening. This is why I was so afraid to make this trip alone. Yet, I had been doing so well that I kind of felt like I was being a big baby about it. The flight out was perfect, and the days with my publisher went beautifully. I was excited to share about what God had done in my life and the innumerable lessons I've learned. My confidence was renewed, and even though I was totally exhausted from the trip, I wasn't the slightest bit worried about the return flights home. Sure, my heart rate was sky high and my right leg was starting to feel a little weak, but I expected those things to be happening. After the busy days I just had, especially considering I just had to stand in line for an hour to get through security. In fact, I would have been shocked if those things didn't happen. Even though I felt pretty bad about the security line, I made it from Seattle to Detroit in one piece. I even made it on and off the train from one terminal to the next and walked through a crazy tunnel with flashing disco lights without losing my balance or getting sick. Overall, I thought I was doing pretty well. But then the delays started, one after another until it was after 10 p.m., when another delay was announced. I got up to use the restroom. Unfortunately, my right knee started to buckle on the way. Not a good sign. It's sort of like the rumble of thunder just before the downpour. If you can run back inside, you'll be safe from the rain, wind, and lightning. But I had nowhere to run. I needed to get on that plane, and as I made my way back to my gate, the noise and light began to intensify. I decided to sit at another empty gate that was far enough away to be quiet, but close enough that I could still hear the announcements. It seemed like a good plan at the time. However, when they announced that the flight had been postponed until noon the next day, I was too far away and too slow to make it to the counter before everyone else was already in line. I managed to text Greg with the new flight info, but I was in bad shape by this point. Dizzy, weak, blurred vision, and having a hard time bearing weight on my right leg. And then the long wait in line. That was the final straw that did me in. When I reached the front of the line, all I could do was lean on the counter and say, "I need help." The woman was busy printing my new ticket for the next day. "What do you need help with?" I couldn't think. I could barely stand. I didn't know what to say, so I muttered, I just don't know what to do. Can't stand. The lady told me to go sit to the side, and she would call someone. That was an hour ago. It is quiet, and I'm sitting with my legs on the metal chairs. I keep looking at my phone. There are multiple missed messages from Greg. I know I could use my phone to help me figure out something, but I just don't know what or how. As I stare at my phone, realizing just how incapable I am. The tears start to trickle down my face, and then they pour. I am all out sobbing when a woman walks up to see what I need. I do my best to pull myself together. The woman explains that the airline is not covering hotels due to this being a weather-related delay, but that they can give me a discount voucher. What do I do with that?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.